political appointee made by the BJP government. And it's a big milestone for the Big B, the Shehenshah of Bollywood turned 75. We join all of India and millions of Big B fans in wishing him a long and healthy life.
डॉन का इंतजार तो 11 मुल्कों की पुलिस कर रही है लेकिन सोनिया
But our big focus on Face Off tonight, a Railways Inquiry Committee headed by the Chief Safety Officer came out with a much-awaited report on what exactly led to that Elphinstone stampede, a disaster which killed 23 people back on the 29th of last month. And far from naming and shaming people responsible, far from fixing accountability for what actually happened, it actually diverted the whole thing. It fixed accountability on the rain gods. It said there were rumors that were spread amongst the crowd, and that's why there was that stampede. It was an act of God, not an act of omission or commission. This is a blatant and unabashed cover-up. A string of questions jump out on the violations that have happened that led to that stampede, and two, the clean chit that's been given to politicians, that's been given to bureaucrats, that's been given to every single railway official whose job should have been on the line for this stampede. It is criminal that in 2017 people should die because of stampedes. It is criminal that in 2017 people should be using British-era footover bridges. Which is why we're asking tonight on Face Off, is this simply nothing but a cover-up exercise?
A rickety British-era footover bridge connecting two of Mumbai's busiest local train stations. A peak hour rush, a surging crowd, and then a bout of heavy rain. And all hell breaks loose. The Elphinstone stampede killed 23 Indians. With tough questions on massive infrastructural shortcomings staring you in the face.
This is exactly from where people went out and on the adjacent side of Elphinstone Road station, the tragedy took place. You can see how narrow this footover bridge is. Even two persons for them to walk side by side is difficult.
12 days on, the tragedy takes the shape of another of many Mumbai tragedies. The Railway Inquiry Report's culprit, if you please, was heavy rain and rumours of the bridge collapsing. Besides the rush, of course. So the recommendations, stop people carrying heavy luggage, restrict people with heavy loads.
When the heavy rain started around 10-4 a.m., suddenly the crowd started building, the people were not moving out, and some people were carrying a heavy sack of flowers also on their head. And one person, he got imbalanced and that sack fell down, and he just shouted, the pull gir gaya, pull gir gaya. Suddenly, there was a gridlocking at the moment. People were running behind, people were jostling from the behind, and this stampede happened.
That's all. No fixing accountability, no punitive action, no transfers, no stringent punishment. What of basic norms on the height and width of the bridge being ignored? What of zero administrative response to the population explosion amid creaking infrastructure? What about holding officials and netas to account for 23 needless deaths? And what about all the unheeded warnings? Questions arise also on over 11 crore rupees that were sanctioned by the centre for widening this particular bridge. The work should have been carried out months back. The Railways has taken a step back on this one. A panel headed by a former CVC will submit a report on the delay within 3 months. Bottom line, Elphinstone 2 looks set to become part of that much-touted spirit of Mumbai that recovers from the worst depths even without corrections, only waiting for the next calamity to strike. Is the Elphinstone tragedy report the ultimate cover-up exercise? That's the debate tonight on Face Off at 9.
All right, the time to fix accountability is now. The Railways is shying from it. We'll try and attempt to do that here on Face Off. Tonight, joining us on the debate, Clyde Krastow is spokesperson of the NCP, Ayaz Memon, senior journalist, resident commentator here at CNN News 18 and a lifelong Mumbaikar. Shaina NC, spokesperson of the BJP, will be joining us in a moment. Baris Pathan, AIMIM leader. Sujay Kantawala is lawyer at the Bombay High Court. And Srikanth Vishwanathan is CEO of Janagraha. I'll start with you, Ayaz. You know, some years ago, there was this famous headline, "No one killed Jessica." This was the day after Jessica Lal's killers were let free. Today, I'm reminded of that same headline. No one killed 23 Mumbaikars. Rain did. Rumor did. No one else did. That is what the report today has done. It has basically absolved everybody else of all their responsibility and blamed it all on the rain.
Well, you know, I think Zaka, the simple explanation to that would be that really they have no leg to stand on. I would have thought that the authorities would have shown some contrition, accepted that there have been, you know, there's not been enough done, there's been neglect. But no, what they have done is they have left it to divine forces. They've said it's because of very heavy rainfall and somebody shouting something, and you know, because of that there was a stampede. I think even if you assume that that is, you know, right, they're saying it out of with well-intentioned statement, the fact is that that was at best a precipitate, you know, kind of situation. The problem was already there, that the bridge was just too narrow. The population around Lower Parel and Elphinstone station, which is where I'm not sitting too far away from, that has increased, you know, several hundred times over the last 20-25 years after the Midlands were developed. And nobody has had the foresight or the thought to do anything about commuter welfare, about commuter safety, till something magic, horrendous like this happens.
I'm just going through this report, Varis Pathan. It says, you know, there should have been CCTVs. It says there should have been a GRP person. There should be more walkie-talkies. It talks about, you know, the booking office, which was close to where the incident happened. It should not have been there. Commuters carrying heavy luggage and baskets should not be allowed to travel during peak hours. More hotlines and wirelesses should be used. Everything is mentioned except naming people, except fixing accountability. Everything else is responsible.
This is what is disturbing, Zaka. That 23 people, I would call it a mass murder. Knowingly, the government's lackluster attitude that they did not repair the bridge, because it's in several years, people have been writing them letters to the railway ministries, to the government of the day, that kindly see to it that 3 lakh commuters are travelling every day from this foot over bridge. And it has become very deliberate, and a day will come when this bridge is going to collapse. But the government of the day did not heed to it. They did not take any steps to ensure the safety and security of the commuters who are travelling every day. And now, when we had asked them to file an FIR, they did not file an FIR. Instead of that, they appoint a 5-member committee, and the committee today gives a report. This is a shameless act of the cover-up, but we will not tolerate this again. What the report says, this is an act of God. Because of rains, and havoc was created, and the people died in a stampede. What kind of statement is this? Shows the total insensitiveness of the government. This shows the total non-emotional feelings of the government towards the nation. The entire country is mourning the death of the 23 innocent people who died there. But who is responsible? The railway authorities. Why no charge for negligence is leveled against them till date? Section 304 should have been applied upon them, Jaka.
No,
Section 304, like Amitabh Bachchan's case.
There is not one railways official who has been held responsible. The report basically says there are certain inadequacies need to be covered. Staff should be better equipped. Yeah. Coordination needs to be improved. Any penal action? No. There is only some suggestions to improve infrastructure. Clive Trastor, 23 people are dead. Is the railways now going to tell the families of these people that their relatives, their loved ones died because there was not enough walkie-talkies, or that the booking office should have been shifted from there? I mean, are we a banana? Who are we going to, Zaka, hold accountable for this?
Zaka, I have a copy. I think both of us have the copy of this report that is there. You know, and to start with, I'll tell you, it just sounds like a complete sham. You know, these people, whoever these people who are on the committee, are making a mockery of this whole incident, and you know, they're mocking, you know, the people who have, you know, lost their lives. You know, there are a lot of points here, and if you allow me to, you know, there are a couple of points which I need to highlight to you. Okay, you've gone through all about, you know, CCTVs and walkie-talkies and stuff like that. Those things, I mean, those are like, you know, it's like an immature conversation. There are stuff like, you know, ban on vendor compartment during peak hours and festival rush. Now, let me tell you, people who live in Mumbai and who know about Elphinstone Station, it's close to Dadar Flower Market. Okay. Now, if you are going to remove a vendor compartment during peak hours, that's the time when people come to sell flowers and a lot of things happen around the Dadar market there. Okay. And during festival rush is another point that is input here. Now, during festivals, with the times like Diwali and, you know, festivals like that, when people come to sell their flowers. Now, if you are going to ban a compartment during that time, where are these people going to go?
No, what about the Dabbawalas? The Mumbai.
No, that's,
you know,
exactly.
Food,
I'm coming to that.
What about the Dabbawalas? Are you going to ban the Dabbawalas?
I'm coming to that point. Yeah, I'm coming to that point. Now, they're talking about, you know, during peak hours, they're not going to allow these people to use that foot over bridge. But then where are these people going to, how are they going to go out of the station?
Yeah, exactly.
You want them to cross the railway tracks and have more deaths?
Exactly.
Are you going to allow them to have more deaths that way? The point here is, Zaka, nowhere in this report, okay, I'm holding this, I have a copy of this report, nowhere in this report it says that they're going to widen the size of the bridge from 77 inches to the exact norm of the bridge that has to be there. Nowhere is it mentioned that they're going to have new foot over bridges. If they're going to ban vendors from taking that bridge, nowhere is it mentioned that they're going to have a separate bridge for these vendors.
Look at the thing.
They're going to have RPF,
let me bring in, as we await China NC, let me bring in Sujaya Kantawala as well as Srikanth Vishwanathan into this debate. The point is this, that right from the get-go, this whole probe was flawed. I don't think anywhere in the world you will have an agency that's responsible for the operations and for the safety of the passengers who use their service probing itself on its role on whether it is guilty of dereliction of duty or criminal negligence, and that agency gives itself a clean chit. I mean, what sort of probe is that, Sujoy Kantawala?
Zaka, can I make a quick point on this?
Let Sujoy Kantawala respond.
Exactly, Zaka. Zaka, as a lawyer who regularly argues that there is a violation of principles of natural justice and fair play in proceedings, this is very disturbing because the judge, the prosecutor and the defense are all one the same.
Yes.
So what are you ultimately going to expect? So therefore, it's going to be a one-sided report. They will ignore corruption, they will ignore modernization. And the worst part is that they say that pool gir gaya, but here it looks like Mumbai kar ko full banana hai, total FOOL. And let me be very clear, I am a proud Mumbaikar. Mumbaikars are not going to accept this kind of an approach. And this report requires serious judicial scrutiny. This report cannot be accepted on the face value the way it has been tailor-made. This is unacceptable in today's times. With these kind of appalling images and losing lives of so many Mumbaikars who are innocent totally, the railways can't shirk off their responsibility. They can't ignore the fact that there is serious corruption issue in the railways.
Yes.
And that is plaguing this department.
No,
so therefore, this requires serious judicial scrutiny.
And this corruption has come to the fore in this instance as well, Srikanth Vishwanathan, because right after this stampede happened, you know, there were leaks and counter leaks. Arvind Sawant, the MP from that area, put up a letter which purportedly showed in February of 2016 how the then Railway Minister Suresh Prabhu had said 11.86 crores were already sanctioned for expanding this footover bridge from 77 inches to 236 inches. That money was already sanctioned. Till date, nobody knows where that money has gone. Not a brick has been purchased, not a sack of cement has been purchased for the expansion of this bridge. Today, 12 days after 23 people died, the Railway Minister has announced a fresh probe. An ex-CVC will probe where this 11.86 crores has gone after 23 people have died. Right?
So Zaka, clearly accountability has to be fixed. And in my view, we need to move from speaking about what needs to be done to how it needs to be done. Because in our country, for far too long, we've dwelt on what needs to be done and we've repeated ourselves over and over again. In my view, if you are able to corporatize the Mumbai Railway and make it report into the Mumbai Mayor, that's the institutional design that can fix accountability on a Mumbaikar, which will be the Mumbai Mayor, with whom the buck will stop. Because the solution to this is not just fixing the Elphinstone Bridge. Because let's not forget that a few days after the Mumbai stampede, a young girl of 20 years lost her life by falling out of the train. Hmm. And we know for a fact that over the last 5 years, between 15 and 20,000 people have lost their lives trying to travel from point A to point B in Mumbai. This is a completely unacceptable situation, but this can be fixed not through personal accountability of individuals, but through institutional accountability.
No, no, I'm convinced tonight that personal account, it has to start with personal accountability. As we welcome Shaina NC, you know, the railway minister on the day the stampede happened, went to Elphinstone. Welcome to the debate. He went to the Elphinstone footover bridge to the stampede site, yes. And he said, "We will do whatever it takes to fix accountability." May I start by asking why this report today doesn't fix accountability? Right. Not one railway officer has been named. Not one person has been suspended.
First,
not one person has lost his job. No FIR has been filed. Is this accountability?
First, Zaka, the railway minister is not absolving the railway department of any faulty work. And that is the reason you have the structural audit for all footover bridges and not just one, with immediate effect to start work on any issues where the footover bridges are a matter of safety or security. Now coming to the railways, clearly there is a red tapism and bureaucracy which the railway minister, Mr. Goyal himself, has admitted. And that's why a free hand for budget, a free hand to do away with red tapism, and a free hand to say 16 collaborative agencies, whether it's the Western Railways, whether it's the GM of Central Railways, BMC, or the other agencies which need
but
to work
Shaina,
together.
Who is responsible for the 23 deaths?
Who are selling
give
the product
one name.
On the pushover
no, no, it's all fine to say
now.
Rain was responsible, rumors were responsible, lack of civics. No,
you
I'm asking you a pointed question. Pointed question. Was the GM Western
Zaka,
Railways' name taken?
Zaka,
was the Chief Safety
answer.
Officer Western Railways' name taken? Was the station master at Elphinstone Bridge, was his name taken? Somebody should be held accountable. You can't go back to the families of those 23 people and say, oh, barish ke wajah se aapke parivar wale mar gaye.
But can I just give you a pointed answer, please, if you allow me?
Yes.
You cannot name one person when there are multiple issues. Was the rain unprecedented? Yes, it was. Were there vendors selling their products on the footover bridge who should not have been? Yes, that was the case, but that has been addressed with the BMC. Was there a certain question when it came to maybe somebody who chose to spread a rumor that the bridge is going to fall? Yes, that may have been the case. So a report shows multiple things. It's not absolving the railways of their work, which is security and safety of passengers.
Shujay Kantawala wants to respond
railway,
to you. Shujay
well
Kantawala and
Baris
Pathan want to respond to you.
Railway,
I look at this report,
well
it blames everything from walkie-talkies to CCTVs to booking offices. It doesn't name one person. Shujay yes. Kantawala, then Baris Pathan.
I just want to say one thing, that you just need to go on any prime time, at any prime time on any railway station, and I challenge you if you can hear your own voice. Forget about somebody else shouting and spreading a rumor or something.
Yeah.
You can't hear your own voice. There are thousands of people. So where is the question of somebody shouting pool and all this and all? It's all crap. This is all unbelievable. And this requires judicial scrutiny. This report is unacceptable on the face of it.
Shaina.
May I please come in, Zaka?
Respond to it.
See, if we go into history and a blame game of how this bridge was built, which was the government at the time, what happened, where were the money spent, why do tender process take so long, we will only be constantly discussing problems.
No, we are constantly only discussing problems. That is the problem.
Let's fundamentally
we are only constantly discussing accidents after the accident happened.
We have to move ahead.
You know, I have a suggestion tonight. One second. Baris Pathan and Clyde Crasto, I am convinced tonight that there is a petition pending before the Bombay High Court right now. It was filed by concerned citizens after the Elphinstone stampede. It says criminal action needs to be taken against railway officials for dereliction of duty. I am convinced, Baris Pathan, Clyde Crasto, I am convinced tonight that that's where we need
Zaka,
to start.
Even I am convinced.
Baris Pathan.
Zaka, even I am convinced. If Shaina will kindly see the report which is filed by the five-member committee. Kindly allow me to say, the five-member committee have said they have ruled out issue of poor infrastructure or negligence. Now, Zakka, you answered to my question. This bridge was constructed in the year 1867. Now, what was the population at that time and today? What is the population of Mumbai? Almost 3 lakh passengers are travelling every day in this foot over bridge. So, does it not require repairs? Why did the tender was there, but it was not accepted? Then why did you not make it? Why were you waiting to see that the 23 people have died? Then only you will start work. Now you have started putting cameras. Now you have put up that okay, nobody will be allowed to carry luggage. But why can't the government prevent it beforehand? Why are you waiting to see that?
No, at the cost of sounding cynical. Clyde, I'm coming to you. But at the cost of sounding cynical, one second, China. At the cost of sounding cynical, I can say this, that, you know, God forbid the next railway accident will happen. And we will have China NC and Varis Pathan and Clyde Crasto on this program debating the same old things. If we need that to stop, we have to start by booking people in FIR. Name officials in FIR.
Agreed.
Put the general manager railways, put his name on the FIR. Let one person lose his job.
Absolutely.
Because of a railway accident.
Zakka, please allow me to
allow me to make one simple point and I will share.
Okay.
Zakka, the Supreme Court in Ansal Brothers case of Uphad Theatre tragedy have clearly stated that section 304 is applied for negligence.
Yes.
They are convicted. In Bhopal tragedy case also 304 is applied. And the case is pending, so why not in this case?
So if it can apply to the Ansal brothers, why wouldn't it apply to railway officials?
That's exactly.
Clyde Crasto.
If Ryan Pinto's case can be applied, why not in Ryan Pinto's case, a child is killed.
He's now having to file for anticipatory bail in the case against the Pintos. Why won't the same thing happen to the GM Railways?
Zakka,
how is this case different from that?
Zakka.
Yes,
Zakka, I want to take it forward from where Mr. Varis Pathan has spoken. Okay, I completely agree with you. After the Bhopal gas tragedy, private people in charge of private institutions were brought into the ambit of 304A. Okay, the same happened with the Ansal brothers in the Delhi, you know, Upar Cinema case. Now is the time to bring the state and the government bodies into the ambit of 304A. You have to get this done, because now the BJP is their government. If they are so proactive and if they really want to have, you know, courage of conviction, they need to come now and bring all these people, the state and the government, into the ambit of 304.
Let one official be held accountable, lose his job, or be sent to jail. I am convinced railway accidents will stop the next day.
What are you achieving by that, Zakka?
You are fixing accountability, China. You are fixing accountability. People will be afraid to go to jail. People will be afraid to go to jail. If Warren Anderson can be booked for 304A, if the Ansal brothers can be booked for 304A, why not GM Railways? Why not Chief Safety Officer? We have on average more than 300 railway accidents every year in this country. Not one railway official has been booked.
Why? The station in charge.
Yes.
The station officer in charge. And I have one more suggestion. All these fancy railway boards where they have these fancy tea parties and they pass all these resolutions, they should have a citizen on that committee. Because today, what happens in these closed rooms, nobody knows about it. So now, from henceforth, on every railway board, there should be a citizen's voice also. That is very important. We cannot have these kind of tragedies, and we cannot use 150-year-old bridges with all these towers and all these huge population coming up.
China, as far as Elphinstone is concerned, look at the number of red flags that have been raised over the last 5 years. In 2012, there's a railway board circular on footover bridges which mandates that all FOBs should be at least 6 meters wide. In 2014, the Shiv Sena MP from that area, Arvind Sawant, writes to the then Railway Minister on footover bridges, no action is taken. In 2015, the DRM of the Central Railway says the Elphinstone Bridge is structurally weak. In February of 2016, Suresh Prabhu replies to Arvind Sawant, says that an amount of 11.86 crores is already under consideration and sanctioned for expansion of this footover bridge. Nobody knows where that 11.86 crores is gone. A week or two after that, the same MP, Mr. Sawant, puts up posters all around that constituency and says he has been successful in getting the railways to expand the footover bridge. In July 2016, the CAG report highlights the very same problems, says about half a dozen FOBs in suburban stations are unfit for use. And today, here we are, October of 2017, 12 days after 23 people have died. These repeated red flags have all been ignored and not one person has been held accountable. What good are these red flags then? Shaina, why are we raising these red flags then? And where is this 11.86 crores? Nobody seems to know. Today there's an ex-CVC probe to find out where this 11.86 crores
are. Now that your monologue is over.
No, no, it's not a monologue. It's a monologue for the 23 people who died, Shaina. Please understand the pain of those families.
You cannot mock the 23 people who died.
I'm sorry. 23 Indians died. Please do not mock them.
Done away with red tapism. Done away with tender process, which goes into one year plus.
I will continue on monologue after monologue, program after program, night after night. If people die in this country because they have to use British era bridges, please don't mock them. Please don't mock them. My humble request to you. Please do not mock 23 Indians' families who had to die for no fault of theirs.
Statement. I'm not mocking them. You are constantly repeating as if to suggest what was the audit about the footover bridges. It's not limited to Elphinstone. It's every bridge
if
in the city.
If at any one point in the last five years, any official of the railways heeded to these red flags, today those 23 families will not be grieving.
That is the only solution. The solution is to have systems in place. I'm sorry, this is not a Congress BJP issue. This is not a politically partisan issue. I hold every political party responsible.
This was raised in 2012. This was raised in 2014. This was raised in 2015, 16. If at any point Clyde Crasto and Varis Patan, if at any point Ayaz Memon, if one railway official took cognizance of these red flags, today those 23 people would not have had to die. Ayaz Memon.
So Zaka, I think, you know, if you remain politically
agnostic
and not...
And for those who are trying to score political one-upmanship, they could have gone to the BMC and they could have spoken to their government
there too. Who was in charge? I think the issue is, you know, currently as it's happened, they shouldn't have sidestepped the problem and said it's an act of God or a rumor or heavy rains. I mean, this was the monsoon season. And, you know, there's this great flawed, you know, kind of impression about Mumbaikars who have this spirit to endure and bear everything. I can tell you people who commute every day by train, by suburban train, they're actually living on edge. You know, they travel in packed compartments. They go through a lot of hardship. They travel for an hour, hour and a two. A lot of women who travel actually do their whatever the work in house, you know, cutting vegetables and all in the train. They are living a life on edge. So anything, something untoward happens, yes, there will be panic. There will be stampede. And a lot of the suggestions which have come up in this report are saying exactly what should have been done earlier. Widen the footbridge or the footover bridge. Move the vendors somewhere else. Get some cameras in place. Now the point is, all this wisdom is coming post facto when it could have been done much earlier, maybe 10 years earlier, 15 years earlier. But now, I think to sidestep it, I think the best course of action would have been to acknowledge, yes, there has been a massive goof up by the people who are responsible. And then work backwards from
there. I don't understand why they just don't, the railway authorities just don't come out in front of the public and say, yes, we have made a mistake. We are sorry for it. And we are going to see to it that this never happens again. Whatever has happened is very sad.
But we are never going to let it happen again. We are also Indians. We are also patriots. That is what they need to come in front of the public and say. Not by giving such kind of reports where everything they do within closed doors and then they say we are not accountable. The problem is unless you don't hold these bureaucrats accountable and they don't have the fear of arrest.
Yes.
They will continue to perpetuate these crimes on the Mumbaikar and other Indian citizens.
No, Waris Pathan, if the report is basically going to say, oh, yeah, public ki galti thi, there was a rumor, there was a stampede, there were heavy rains, everybody except railways officials are responsible for what happened in Elphinstone. So, what are they going to do? Are they going to take all the people and send them back to classroom and give them a civics lesson? Is that what the government of the day wants to do?
They don't want to fix up accountability on the people who are responsible for the act. They don't read the Supreme Court judgment, the guidelines of negligence, the meaning of negligence. They have forgotten. And the shameless people they are, Zaka, I am so disturbed to tell you, but let me bring it before the nation that on that particular night, the mayor of Mumbai was celebrating at his bungalow along with football players. The leader of BJP, Kirin Somaiya, was playing Dandiya Ras and Garba. This was shown in the entire media. This is the insensitiveness and the lackluster attitude of the government which the entire poor people of the nation are facing today.
I'll tell you, Zaka,
tomorrow I am holding a dharna to see that we will have an FIR registered against this. This is not acceptable.
Don't make it so trivial. No, it's not trivial. People have died.
I am bringing the truth.
Let's not make it trivial. People have died. Somebody needs to be held accountable for it.
The point is, the government is not paying attention.
It will not. Some accountability needs to be fixed.
The attitude of the government comes to play now. Every person has to see what the government says. They are right. We have to follow that blindly. Today they give a clean sheet without filing a single FIR. On the death of 23 innocent Mumbaikars.
What is stopping the government from filing an FIR? Why is the railways not filing an FIR?
Yes, that is what I am asking.
Is there no criminal negligence?
Why no FIR?
Here? Is there no criminal negligence here?
It should be here now, Sagar. China is speechless. She can hear, but she will not reply.
I'm asking a simple question.
But that criminal negligence is that of the railways. That criminal negligence is that of... May I complete my point?
Yes.
I am saying that we can continue to have this game where we are constantly blaming each other. We are taking the onus. We are a responsible government. Understand, we have not absolved ourselves of anything. If at all we are saying, here on, please move forward, have the budget. Don't have any budgetary constraints for safety, security. For 18 months, give the GMs of the railway the absolute power. So they are held responsible. Up until now, you are just passing the buck. This tender was not passed. The MP could have gone to BMC. BMC should have responded. The vendors who were present there, who does that jurisdiction come under?
What is the budget allocated for the safety of the people? Are you aware about that?
You do this always, Zaka. It's no point asking me a question if you don't have the patience.
No, it's not me. It's Waris Pathan. It's not me. But you know what? I have a fundamental problem when the report says public ki galti hai. No, hang on. One second. If everybody is going to say public ki galti hai, then why are you paying compensation to the people who died?
That's what I want to highlight.
Wo to public ki galti hai, na?
It's not just
Why are you paying compensation to the people who died? Only now is somebody asking for criminal negligence and accountability. Rumor ki wajah se mar gaye. Clyde, because you have given him the power, you have given him the funds, and you have given him the guidelines. Who has been held responsible? Give me one railway official's name. Give me one railway's official's name who has been held responsible. Give me one. One name.
Not a single one.
You're again going into backslash.
Not a single name.
What do you mean back with that?
Why is your government silent, transparency,
Clyde.
No, no, it's very smart to talk about future when you don't want to put the onus on somebody.
Clyde.
Zaka, now can I talk?
Yeah, Clyde, yeah.
If you have systems in place, Clyde, only then can we move forward.
Zaka, it's a very smart way to talk about going to the future. No, but you have to put the onus on somebody and then move forward. It's a very smart way to subvert and divert the whole attention from somebody who has to be blamed.
How do you
now
put the onus when
there are 16 agencies? How do you put the onus
when there are multiple causes and reasons?
No.
How do you put
Zaka,
the onus
talk?
If there
because
are
now
other
FIR
people who come into play, whether it's the vendor's
I'm asking a simple question, Srikanth Vishwanathan. Simple question. How does it work in countries abroad? In the US, when there's an Amtrak accident, if there's an Amtrak accident, or let's say there's a Eurorail accident, are people responsible for it? I have got other people also. Let me get Srikanth Vishwanathan also.
If there's an accident, what's the point in sitting here and you're not going to allow me to make my point?
Clyde, one second, I'll come back to you. I'm just trying to understand from Srikanth Vishwanathan.
No, but you've not given me a chance. You're allowing everybody
I'm sorry,
to talk.
I'm sorry that China took away much of your time. I'm sorry about that. But Srikanth Vishwanathan.
How
does it happen? How does it happen in other countries? If there's an Amtrak accident, if there's a Eurorail accident, are those railways officials of those respective agencies not held accountable at all?
So in more developed cities, Zaka, we have institutional mechanisms to fix accountability because the system is clear on who the buck stops with. We have created a system where things are so unclear and obfuscated that we're not able to fix accountability on a particular person, on a particular organization. The solution to this, going beyond criminal negligence and FIR, is aggressive decentralization to give power in the hands of the people. What that means is that the Mumbai Council and the Mumbai Mayor, who represent the people of Mumbai, should be the controllers of their own destiny. We cannot have a Mumbai Railways, which is one of the busiest and largest rail systems in any city in the world, but perhaps one of the worst in terms of infrastructure and safety, to be managed by an organization that has no accountability to the people of Mumbai. Further, the growth of Mumbai, for example, in terms of building plan sanctions, in terms of town planning, location of offices and job centers, etc., have to be coordinated with other agencies, including the Mumbai Railways. So we have created a system where each organization within the city does its own work without coordinating with each other, and the end of it, when mishaps like this happen, we are not able to move beyond criminal negligence and FIR and hold our political leaders accountable for putting in place systems and processes that in future will prevent these and help fix accountability in the future.
I get the point about institutional accountability. I completely buy that, but I think we have to begin with personal accountability. And here's the thing that I don't understand. If tomorrow, God forbid, and I'm saying this 100 times, God forbid, if there's going to be an accident in, say, the Delhi Metro, you know exactly which officer is responsible. If there's going to be an accident at, say, involving one of the private airlines, you know exactly where to fix accountability. Why does that not apply to the Indian Railways? Look at accident after accident. I've got, here's the list of accidents that have happened in the recent past, the very grievous ones. In 2016, in November of 2016, there was a derailment in Kanpur, 14 coaches of the Indore-Patna Express derailed, 150 people killed. Not one railway official was held accountable. In Rafiganj in Bihar, where again 140 people killed, the Howrah Rajdhani being one of our premier trains, derailed on a bridge. The bridge was blamed. Not one official was suspended. In August 1995, the Purushottam Express rammed into a stationary Kalindi Express. The station master was suspended for a few days and then he was reinstated back to his job. You see what I'm getting at? If one person, and I keep saying this again, it starts with personal accountability. If one person is held accountable, loses his job, or is sent to jail for criminal negligence, then it sends out a message. Why do we have laws for heinous crimes, for murder, for rape? Why do we have stringent laws? Because it sends out a message that this is unacceptable in a civilized society. And if rape and murder are unacceptable, Sujay Kantawala, criminal negligence also should be unacceptable, and it should apply to the Indian Railways as well. Shuja Kantawala.
Absolutely, Zaka. We are all consumers. The railways have a statutory responsibility, and one of the incidents which you explained was that when a
train rams into a stationary train.
Yeah.
Nobody was held responsible. So where was the fault of any other person at that stage? So therefore, these kind of inquiries and these kind of reports which are internal are completely sham and bogus and are not worth the paper they are printed on. They all need to be, they all need to withstand judicial scrutiny
from a sitting
High Court judge. And we can make our submissions over
there. Yes, I agree.
Zaka, quick round of closing comments.
Under the High Court's direction and under the Chief Justice of the High Court, a high-level inquiry should be initiated for the incident that took place.
I hope the Bombay High Court takes comment.
Let this report be placed before the Mumbai High Court.
There is already a petition.
Let the license be taken by the Mumbai High Court.
There is already a petition that's been filed and it's pending before the Bombay High Court. I pray and I hope
state government
that
must,
the good senses of the judges will prevail.
The High Court to initiate an inquiry.
That they will order an inquiry. You can't have the Indian Railways have an inquiry into whether its own officers were guilty of
dereliction. We are fighting for
the manual. That is why I say that the inquiry should be conducted by a High Court judge.
I'm going to wrap it up. Let the report be made public before the entire nation.
That's it, Zaka, we want.
I'm going to reiterate what the Railway Minister said on the day that the stampede happened. He said, we will take and we will do whatever it takes to fix accountability in the system. Let's begin with personal accountability. Let's begin with railway officials losing their job, with railway officials being sent to jail for criminal negligence, then let's see how many accidents happen. I'm going to leave it at that. Thank you very much for joining us on this panel. Like I said, you know, Mumbaikars are famous for the chalta hai attitude. Chalta nahi hai. Aur aisa chalega bhi nahi. We have to stop, we have to fix accountability and then we can move forward. I'm going to take a quick break. When we come back on the other side, a big ruling today by the Supreme Court, sex with a minor wife is rape, period. The Supreme Court spelling it out clearly, saying that the age of consent cannot